Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to today's video where I'm going to show you two looks with the newest palette from Essence. Welcome to Miami. Welcome to Miami. But basically, if you haven't clicked out right now when I did that, you are one of mine. So just, you know, hit the subscribe button and the bell button because this is kind of what you get here. Yeah, also colorful looks, neutral looks. I'm slightly orcish with me, which means I'm an olive. And that's kind of important today because the shadow that I have on my eyes, it warped a hint. Not a lot, actually. So that's actually also very impressive, which I forgot to mention at the end of the video. Because at the end of the video, I give you my thoughts on this palette. We will start with the two looks that I did, though. And that means that you can see the palette in action. The palette is, as far as I know, only available in Europe. But I will link down below where you can find it. I got mine in store at Kruidvat, or was it Trekpleister? One of the two. I don't remember exactly what it retails for. I think 5 or 6 euros. But I will put the correct pricing in the screen. I have this one, and I also have the sister, which is the Roma, which is this one. This is what she looks like, and I really want to start playing with that one as well. But first, this one. Timestamps will be listed down in the description box for the two looks and the review part. And what else did I want to say? Oh yeah, the makeup is listed down below as well. Yeah, just before we go any further, grab a drink and a snack, put your feet up and enjoy, because here comes... Well, look number one with this pretty summery palette. I am going to start with the purple with the flamingo in it. I'm using the Natasha Denona base in shade Light. And it is still sticky, but not as sticky as it can be. So it has set a little. I'm tapping the shadow into place. The brush that I'm using is a little bit denser. It's one from Beauty Bay. It's the number 205. I do want to connect it a little bit with my lower lash line. I'm going to go to a blending brush that is clean. I'm going to blend the edges a little. I'm actually going to grab, I don't know, the shade with the ice cream on top. I'm going to blend the edge a little. I'm going to go back to the shade with the flamingo on it. Just going to tap it over and kind of blend it into the other shade a little. I am grabbing the shade underneath the flamingo. Just placing it in the inner corner. And it won't really show up because it's very close to my skin tone, but that's okay. I'm just going to blend it a little bit into the purple. I am going to deepen it up. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to the darkest purple with the brush that I'm using now. It does not really matter. And I'm going to place it. Okay, that's nice. And this is True to Pan, the color that I get. Nice pigmentation. I am dipping in constantly though, just to make sure that I have maximum pigment. I'm going to blend it into the first layer a little bit, and then I'm going to go back to that shade, that purpley, to re-intensify it a little, I think. They blend into each other very, very well. So now I'm going to go back to the flamingo just with the same brush, because it does not matter. And I'm cleaning my brush on a towel that I have here in between. Or a microfiber towel, it's actually... back to the shade with the ice cream. And a little bit of the darker shade on my lid. Let's grab also the brown to see, the darkest brown, to see if I can maybe make it a little bit more dark. Okay, so I do create a hint more depth. That's nice. I have here a gel primer that I'm going to use on one eye, and on the other eye I'm not. You can also use a glitter glue, only for me. If I use a glitter glue, it creases. So that's why I'm using this. I'm going to go to my bottom lid first. So I'm grabbing a little bit of the jelly primer on the back of my hand and coat my brush and just press the brush on my lower lid. And I'm going to do that for both eyes just because it's the lower lid. A lower lid, I can use a glitter primer because it won't crease, but it's just nice to have something that makes it stick a little bit extra. Then I'm going to go into the purpley shimmer. I'm going to press it on top. Now for one eye, this one, I'm going to just press the jelly primer on. I'm not going to clean up my lid. Then I'm going to kind of wipe off the excess. Then I'm going to go first into that purpley shimmer. And here in the crease where I'm patting now, I'm going to make sure that the jelly is saturated. I'm going to go into the goldeny, well, the orangey shimmer more. Oh, this is a combination I haven't done in such a long time and it's so lovely. Okay, one side the orange, other side the purple, and I'm going to make sure that they mix nicely. So one side, I'm just flipping my brush on the corner. Now while purple and orange don't want to mix in matte shades, they usually blend very nicely if you use a shimmer. So that's a very great way of using shadows that are opposite the color wheel. I do want to intensify my crease a little bit. So I'm going to go back to the darker purple, the matte shadow. I'm just going to blend the edge here. Okay, and then I'm grabbing a brush that's a little bit more fluffy and open. And I'm going to go into that flamingo shade again. Yeah, like this. I'm going to do the same on this eye, but without the glitter primer. So I'm cleaning my brush. Then I'm going to go to the purple shimmer. And this is dry. Let's see what it does dry. Okay, it's okay, but it's kind of lackluster a little, which is fine. Where's my spray? So what I'm grabbing then is I'm grabbing setting spray. You can also grab just a little bit of water, load up my brush, spray the brush so that it's damp, and then press it on. And the reason that I'm doing this one eye with and one eye without is so that I can see if the shimmers crease on me. You know that you have a line of eyelid where there used to be shadow. Let's go to the gold that's in here. Yeah, I thought so. I want a little bit more help in the inner corner. I'm going to finish off the look and I'll be right back. I finished off the look with half lashes from Veve in the style Smoky. For eyeliner, I grabbed one of the Lethal, no, Unearthly Cosmetics gel liner pots in the shade Jam, which is a nice purple. For eye pencil, I grabbed the NYX Epic Wear liner stick in Orangey Zest. And what else? Oh yeah, Lippy is a lip liner from Colourpop in the shade BFF. And then a lip combination. I was extra today, can you tell? A lipstick is from Lethal in the shade Quest. And then on top of that is a lip gloss, also from Lethal in the shade Everything. Yes, and all the makeup that I used will be listed down below in the description box, as will discount codes for some of the things that I used today as well. But I really do like how it turned out. I feel nice and summery, which is very... Oh yes, I forgot inner corner highlight. Oh, stupid me. I used the shade Gumballs from Divina, which is this one. Which is a very nice, very extremely sparkly inner corner shade. And I really like how it turned out. Let me know down below your thoughts. And let's get ready for look number two. Okay. Look number two, my eyes are a little bit stained from the gel liner I used yesterday. I am going to start with the greeny shade in here. And the brush that's a little bit denser. Primer that I have on is the one from Catrice that stays sticky for a long time. For me at least. I'm just going to pack this shadow on. I'm going to go to a blending brush. It's clean. I'm going to blend the edges lightly. When I blend, I start at the outside and I basically do circles and then I go in. So that I blend up and in a bit instead of going like a windshield wiper. Sometimes I do that, but not today. A little bit more of the shade. If you want to darken this up, you can use the brown. Don't use the purple because they won't mix. Okay, let's use that lightest peachy shade. Okay, so I can use that as an eraser shade. And that means that how I'm using it now, just over that border, I can blend with this without bringing the color up any higher. If I am more in my summer color, you will probably see this shade. But now it's just too light. A hint too light. So it does not really show up. But I can lighten it. I can use it to lighten up my inner eyeport area here. Let's go to the dark brown a little bit. Let's see what we can do. Let's use it. Actually creates a nice bit of definition for me. Blending it up, then I'm going to go back to that green and kind of blend that over a little. Let's go to the shimmers. Let's start with the bottom lid first. I am going to go to the jelly primer and a small brush. I'm going to go to the same shimmer as I have, well, the bluey shimmer. Ooh, that's pretty. It's a pretty color. Same thing as yesterday. So one eye I am going to use the jelly primer, the other eye not. Then I am going to go to that bluey shimmer. Then I'm going to go to the orange shimmer, which is next to it. I know I used it yesterday as well, but I want to use it again. I'm changing my mind, so I'm actually tapping the jelly primer on top of the blue. Because I want that orange more on my lid. Better. Okay, with my blending brush, I'm going to go into the blue matte. And then a hint in the brown. For inner corner, I'm going to go to that marbled shade. Which I actually also want to use as a blush. So I'm going to grab a brush that can kind of fit in there. Oh, that's pretty. You like that. Okay. I like that a lot. I am going to finish off the other eye and the rest. And then I'll be right back to show you the final look. And give you my opinion on the palette. I finished off the look with falsies from Unearthly Cosmetics in the style Dreamlike. An eye pencil is from Root Cosmetics. It's one of the flashing lights in... Let's go? Is that? I don't know. It's kind of a minty tealy... That's the color. Lippy is from Unearthly Cosmetics as well in the shade Ava. Inner corner highlight, I did change. I grabbed another shade from Divina. And this time I grabbed the shade Nerd. Which is a little bit more on the bluer side. So that's what I have there. Let me chat to you about this palette. Let's first go to how the palette looks. It's very, very cute, right? Very cute with the outside details, the picture, and then the color story as well. It is actually a cardboard and plastic palette. So the outer part, this part is cardboard, and then where the shadows are in, that's plastic. There's also a mirror. Does it feel cheaply made? Yeah, kinda, but I do like the way that it looks, and at the end of the day, the performance is also very, very important, isn't it? So let's start with the performance. Let's go to the color story first. I really like the color story. I think that the color story really reflects the outside of the palette. Basically, when I grab this palette and I open it up, this is the color story that I'm expecting to see. So I think that they nailed it, and there's actually a lot of brands who are not very good at that. So color story wise, they nailed it. Performance wise, I think it's a very, very nice palette as well. It's a drugstore palette, but I have to say that the way that it performed, the way that the mattes built and blended and layered and basically stayed on my eye, it rivals more expensive palettes. For sure. Shimmers as well, they are maybe a little bit more, I don't want to say, they're not the extremely foiled shimmers that we're kind of used to from indie brands. For drugstore though, I am actually very, very impressed by this. So this one, those are normal shimmers. Well, not really normal. They feel very smooth. They are very nice and sparkly as well. They are in formula a little bit more towards the old school shimmers. And with that, I mean that they're a hint drier, which I like, because on my older eyelids, it means that it won't crease as much. And it also didn't. It did not crease at all. Yesterday, I had one eye with jelly, one eye without jelly. It was pretty warm here. I was outside. I was sitting in the sun. I was sweating. I had no creasing at the end of the day. And I was extremely impressed by that. Also, no fading of the matte shadow. So very, very nice. There's one kind of satin shade in here. There's this one that I actually used as a shimmer blush today. And I think it's very, very pretty. What I think it's very fun with this palette is that you can go neutral and just spruce it up with, I don't know, you do a neutral look, you know, with the brown, deepen everything up, and then do a pop of minty in the inner corner, or purple on your lid, or purple lower lash line. Those are the things that you can really create with this. Now, the looks that I did, it's just what I kind of want to create with the palette. So what I would really, really like is to just, you know, do a look with the purple and the green, because that is what I really love to do. So you can do a purple crease and then that green shimmer on the lid, or vice versa. Shadows, I could get true to pan. I did need to build them up, but I don't mind that at all. This is also what the palette can do. And the nice thing about a buildable formula is that you can, if you go in a little bit slower, just so not really pack them on as I did, you can do an everyday softer, colorful look. If you want to dip your toe in color, I think this is a very, very nice way to go. I'm very excited to try their other palette as well, the Roma. I'm very excited to try that one. That one is a little bit more peachy neutrally, but Essence, you nailed it. I can highly, highly, highly recommend. So yeah, let me know down below what you think of this video. Did you like the looks? Did you get the palette? As far as I know, it's only available in Europe, but I will link down below where you can find it. And that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.